India is now on the moon. The feeling is unreal. The happiness cannot be explained in words. The happiness on the faces of all the ISRO scientists was worth watching. Congratulations to all those scientists. Congratulations to all the Indians. Yes, India is now on the moon. And with the successful landing of Chandrayaan-3, India becomes the first country to land its spacecraft on the South Pole of Moon. From carrying India's first rocket on a bicycle to using a bullock cart to transport a satellite. These images take us through the journey of ISRO's very beginning. From such humble start to the grand mission that reached for the moon and beyond. From carts to cosmos, from bicycle to billion dreams. It's India's story through time, technology and ambition. It's the story of Chandrayaan, India's very own lunar mission. Today on 23 August 2023, whole India is proudly celebrating the successful landing of Chandrayaan-3 on the lunar surface. After America, Russia and China, India becomes the fourth country to successfully accomplish soft landing on Moon. And Chandrayaan-3 becomes the first ever lunar mission in this world to make a soft landing on the South Pole of the Moon. With the success of this mission, India becomes the sole country to conquer lunar South Pole. But do you know how this all started? How was our initial lunar mission? What were the findings of Chandrayaan-1? What was the reason behind the partial failure of Chandrayaan-2? And what are the main objectives of Chandrayaan-3? As we all are celebrating the successful landing of Chandrayaan-3, it's worth reflecting on the ISRO's previous lunar missions, Chandrayaan-1 and Chandrayaan-2. As well as, it is important to explore all the info regarding Chandrayaan-3. So let's dive in. Chandrayaan-1 was the first Indian lunar probe under the Chandrayaan space program. It was launched on 22 October 2008. It had a mission life of 2 years. Back then, because of lack of resources, soft landing on Moon was not possible for India. Hence, Chandrayaan-1 spacecraft carried the Moon Impact probe that was designed to intentionally crash on the lunar surface. Despite its premature conclusion, that mission paved the way for future lunar exploration missions of ISRO. Chandrayaan-1 confirmed the presence of water molecules on lunar surface. This groundbreaking discovery shattered long-held beliefs of Moon's arid nature and opened doors to the possibility of future human habitation on Moon. Other than that, Chandrayaan-1 was successful in mapping and identification of different minerals on the lunar surface. It also took high-resolution images of the Moon's topography that helped in identification of the potential landing sites for upcoming lunar missions. The data collected from the Moon Impact Probe laid the foundation of subsequent missions including Chandrayaan-2 in 2019 and now Chandrayaan-3 in 2023. The Chandrayaan-1 mission is said to be successful as the major objectives of the mission were achieved. For the very first time, it confirmed the presence of water on Moon. After Chandrayaan-1, ISRO launched Chandrayaan-2 on 22 July 2019. Chandrayaan-2 was the second lunar exploration mission developed by ISRO. It comprised an orbiter, a lander, and a rover to study the unexplored South Pole of Moon. Its main objective was soft landing on the South Pole of Moon and operate a rover on the lunar surface. Other than that, the scientific goals of the orbiter were to study the water ice in southern polar regions, to study lunar topography, mineralogy, and lunar exosphere. Chandrayaan-2 was launched successfully. Even it injected in the lunar orbit successfully. But the mission encountered a setback. Vikram lander's engines, which were meant to reduce lander's velocity, actually created too much thrust, following anomalies in the braking system in lander. Small errors accumulated over time, and the lander couldn't turn fast enough to compensate for those errors. It kept on accelerating to reach the landing site. Subsequently, the lander lost contact with ISRO, suggesting that it has crashed onto the Moon. Some ISRO officials often referred it as 17 minutes of terror. Thus, Chandrayaan-2 was unable to achieve its major objectives as it couldn't complete a soft landing on Moon, but still, Chandrayaan-2 is considered as a partial failure. Despite the lander's unfortunate outcome, the orbital component of Chandrayaan-2 is still working and it has made noteworthy contributions. So now, we have come to the most important part of the video, the topic you must be waiting for, the Chandrayaan-3. Chandrayaan-3 is the third lunar exploration mission developed by ISRO. It's a follow-on mission to Chandrayaan-2. It was launched on 14th July 2023 by ISRO to explore the southern pole of Moon, and it feels so good to say that it has successfully landed on the Moon's southern pole. Chandrayaan-3 has three main objectives. The first one is to demonstrate the safe and soft landing on the lunar surface, and happily that's accomplished already. The second one is to demonstrate rover roving on Moon, and the third one is to conduct in situ scientific experiments on the lunar surface. ISRO scientists took a lot of lessons from the failure of Chandrayaan-2 and improved Chandrayaan-3 in every way possible, and that's the reason behind its success. Chandrayaan-3 comprises a propulsion module, a lander, and a rover. It has replaced the orbiter with a propulsion module, as this time the orbiter module of Chandrayaan-2 is still orbiting around the Moon. So the communication between the Chandrayaan-3 lander module and Chandrayaan-2 orbiter module was established successfully. So what's the role of propulsion module? Let's find out. The propulsion module carried the lander and rover from injection orbit to 100 km lunar orbit. Also, this propulsion module has a payload named SHAPE, Spectropolarimeter of Habitable Planet Earth, to study Earth from lunar orbit. On 17th August 2023, lander module comprising Vikram lander and PRAGYAN rover successfully separated from propulsion module. And as of now, on 23 August, Vikram lander had successfully made a soft landing on southern pole of Moon. Now, after some time, Vikram lander will unfold and create a ramp for PRAGYAN rover. Thus, the six-wheeled PRAGYAN rover with the Indian national flag and ISRO logo will descend on lunar surface. It will rove around Moon's southern polar region and generate renderings of the Moon's terrain for the next 14 days. Since PRAGYAN rover is a six-wheeled solar-powered robot-like structure, it will work until there's a day on Moon. And a lunar day, that means a day on the Moon, is equals to 14 days on Earth. So it will derive the information regarding chemical composition and mineral composition of lunar surface via different payloads installed in it. The payloads attachment of lander and rover will carry out several studies and send data about the lunar surface. So let's be hopeful that Chandrayaan-3 mission may succeed in achieving all its objectives. That is all for this video. Other than that, if you want to know more about other topics related to Chandrayaan, I will be uploading some more videos about the same on this topic. The next two videos will be on the topics that why the southern pole fascinates the scientists, and the next video will be on the topic why the last 17 minutes of landing on the Moon are known as the 17 minutes of terror. So stay tuned for next videos, and once again congratulations for the successful landing of our Chandrayaan-3 on Moon.